Hi, good afternoon. My name is Shibata. In my session, I would like to update the status of LTSI. I come from Tokyo just on Monday evening with a long, long flight, and I have a little bit jet lag still. But let's enjoy the conference. Okay. This is my profile. I'm a founder and a project lead of LTSI, Long-Term Support Initiative, that will help industry people to use long-term stable kernel with helpful activities. I was a member of our first Linux, embedded Linux conference that was held in San Jose. It was 10 years ago. So I was a long history of working with Linux community. And also, I'm a board member of the Linux Foundation, so that I'm standing in the middle of Linux community and the industry. So that kind of point of view, we have started the LTSI activities. Before going into detail, let's share the status of current Linux situation. Linux is now running multiple use cases: New York Stock Exchange, London, and Tokyo Stock Exchange is currently running on top of Linux. That's really a mission critical use case. And Amazon, Google, Facebook, and Twitter, such kind of social networking service running on top of Linux. This is a completely different use cases, but still running on top of Linux. And Android TV, camera, router, and car navigation system is running on top of Linux. This is also the very different use cases. There are lots of another use cases running Linux, but these are current situation. So everyone is looking at Linux is the best kernel, or the easiest used for such use cases, different use cases. And another point is that Linux is running on top of multiple architectures: x86, ARM, 3.19, PowerPC. I think IS64 is not so good, but still, code is there. Another important point is that all those use cases, architecture is running on top of the single source code tree. This is a really important point. That's one of our situation. And let's look at the development community. 1,500 developers in participating and contributing Linux in every kernel release from 200 companies. That's the current situation. And yearly, 2.2 million of lines of code increased, and 4,900 files. That it's a yearly increase. This is an incredible situation, and continue to increase developers, as Greg mentioned. And this year is 25 years of anniversary of Linux kernel development. Not just a kind of number, but also maintainers have a great skill to manage subsystems and professional knowledge and technologies. If my company have such kind of maintainers, then my company can create another Linux, but no company is trying to do that. That's the real situation. The Linux kernel is the only one choice of the current industries. So, what's the situation is kernel development? Latest kernel version is 4.8. And it was released October 2nd. Source code, lines of source code is 22 million mega lines of code. It was increased from 4.7. It is 35,000 of lines of code increased from 4.7. And files were 55,000. The 1,100 files are added from 4.7. And in this 4.9, 4.8 kernel, just released 4.8, Linus found a serious problem, and then patch was released that was included in 4.8.1. This is a stable kernel. And now is a merge window period for 4.9 kernel release. Okay. Let's look at the Linux development policy. Every patches will be proposed and accepted by the upstream. The upstream is only the place to accept every single patches, because every patches will be reviewed by the maintainers, skilled maintainers, and tested with other proposals to confirm without any conflict. This is a single place, so that every single patch should be proposed and reviewed by the this upstream activities. This is really an important point. So that, as I mentioned this picture, upstream including new features and fixes. This is a development policy. And development process is like this. Just right after the 4.N was released, 2 weeks of merge window will be opened. Every people can provide, propose their own patch during the merge window. And then 2 weeks after, 2 weeks later, the merge window will be closed, and -RC1 kernel will be released. And after that, there is a stabilization period, and mostly -RC7 or 8, then Linus tried to decide, and it was reasonably stable. Then 4.N+1 will be released. This is a development process, and we should understand this development process, because we will provide our own patches during the merge window period. How long it takes the one kernel version release? I count the number of dates from 3.10 to 4.8. Mostly 60 days or 70 days or so. So I wrote down 65 days. And especially 4.7 and 4.8 took 70 days, just 2 months plus 10 days, or maybe 1 week. This is the speed of development. That means yearly 5 or 6 chance to send merge our own patch into upstream. This is really great, because another open source project is mostly six months time frame, 6 months development process. That means only 2 times per year that will be a chance to merge into upstream. So Linux kernel take a really fast development process. Okay. But as I mentioned, upstream release increase fixes and also new features. But for the use case of industry, mostly don't want it to use new features, but also wanted to have fixes. So for such purpose, there are stable kernel release. That makes a three-part of version, 4.N.N, like such kind of this. This will contain only bug fixes or security fixes. Because of a really fast development process, this lifetime will only just one version, so 65 days or just 2 months or so. So that this is useful for a developer who wanted to use the most recent kernel, but also don't wanted to have experimental features. But for the more industry use case, people wanted to use more longer term use. For that purpose, let's go back to current situation. 4.8 is the current release, and 4.8.1 was a stable kernel, and we are in the merge window process. Current 4.8 kernel was released in October 2nd, so that maybe next week 4.9.9-RC1 will be released. And then stabilization phase will be started. Okay. Okay, let's go back. What kind of patches will backport to stable kernel? That was documented in the kernel source code. It's named called the stable kernel rules, that text. This is the part of the description is right here. This is a really a strict rule that what kind of patch will be backported. And this was published in 2006. It is actually 10 years before. So that during these 10 years, this kind of backported activity is happening. So that's the current situation of Linux kernel, why we are able to use Linux in a stable manner. That is the situation. And so let's go back to stable kernel release. LTS, long-term stable kernel, is right here. This is a more longer-term maintained kernel source code tree. And this was pick one version per year and maintained 2 years. This is the shape of LTS. And everyone is using, everyone is easy to understand. This one is possible to use for the industry purpose. Okay. So why LTS? This is only the tree to get fixes from the community. Industry is not looking at whole source code, but in some use case maybe found a problem. But community is a place where everyone send patch to upstream, so that that will be backported to LTS. So that's a useful situation. And also in the real use case for industry people, tested and confirmed kernels is important and less importance for new features. And fix will be released a number of times and should be applied frequently for the industry products. That's including security and bug fixes. Nowadays, the security and bug fixes more important for compared with old days. The customer is really seriously looking at how this security problem is fixed on top of my devices and so on. And even in LTS, industry people use it. When we found the problem, that should be reported to upstream because of this is an ecosystem situation, and only the place, the upstream is the only the place to report back. And then the fix will be merged into upstream. Then next time we will use LTS, then that will be fixed. That is the reason why we should looking at, one of the reasons we should look at upstream. Okay. So what kind of LTS version is currently providing? From at most bottom side, 3.2 is maintained by Ben Hutchings. He's a Debian maintainer for the Debian stable kernel. Reed Zephan maintained 3.4. He's an employee of Huawei. Huawei is using mostly 3.4 kernel. And Willy Tarieu is French developer. He's maintaining, he's working for network equipment using this kernel. Zilis Rabi is an employee of SUSE Linux. So this is also purpose of a SUSE kernel. 3.14 was maintained by Greg. He's a fellow of the Linux Foundation. This is really a neutral. But 2 years term was already finished. So this is 3.14 was already become an end of life. And also 3.16, Ben Hutching is also maintained for Debian. And 3.18 and 4.1 is maintained by Sasha Levin. He was an employee of Oracle, but he's moving to other companies. But still, he is maintaining this kernel as a stable maintainer. And 4.4. is maintained by Greg Hardman. This is also a neutral point of view. And Greg mentioned that 4.9 will be next LTS, but release not 4.9 is now is a merge window, is not yet released. It's a planned. This is kind of a situation. So that what kernel, LTS kernel, will be possible to use for the industry purpose. So neutral kernel will be better, so that currently 4.4 is the only a choice, but the next one will be 4.9. I will talk about some of the 4.9 story of 4.9 later. Now, how many of fixes included into kernel? The black one is a just a stable kernel, so the lifetime is only 65 days, but still including 600 or 700 fixes, so that we need to look at these fixes. But the red one is LTS. This is containing several thousands of fixes. This will be really useful for industry use. This is the situation. Okay. So let's look at the LTSI. What is LTSI? LTSI is an open source community to create and maintain Linux kernel for longer term. Based on LTS, and we will add another chance to include further patches on top of LTS. That is a technical value. And also, same lifetime with LTS, yearly one release and maintain 2 years. Also, we are industry party to share practice and experience among the industry and discussing each other to share some problem and how to solve that. Such kind of activities, the LTSI. Sorry. This is a picture of relationship is LTS and LTSI. From the bottom side, LTSI will release a year, one version per year, and maintain 2 years, and a frequently and large number of fixes is provided. And on top of LTS, LTSI will provide the help developer to send patches to upstream, and also auto testing framework, and huge testing by contributors, and share test status information problem among the industries, and other vendor required patches on top of LTS. This is a difference from LTS and LTSI. This is the history of LTSI. We have established LTSI in 2011 in Embedded Linux Conference in Prague. So this time is 5 years of anniversary. Thank you so much for your help. And in that time, it was a really exciting time frame for the early time of Android. The Google is providing every 6 months with Android release with a different kernel version. So the manufacturers was really hard to maintain its kernel. That's a started time of LTS, why LTSI is important. And we have successfully integrated with Yocto project in 2012. And we had a workshop and session to share information and discuss some issues in the industry for mostly every Linux Foundation conferences. And this is these are the number of releases on top of LTS, 3.0, 3.4, 3.10, 3.14, and 4.1. But this year's LTS version is not yet released, so that we are not yet decided this year's LTSI version. Oh, this is the shape of LTSI. We are really a small staff. Few number of people is working for LTSI and coordinate workshop session at most of Linux Foundation conferences. Our maintainer is also Greg Hartman. He's a fellow of the Linux Foundation, so that it's really a neutral activities. And working with upstream community and to keep neutral position to be able to use for variety of use cases, we are approaching to a drone code or some other AGL and some other activities to use, please use LTSI. Being more useful for LTSI is beneficial for every people. Okay. Here is the development process of LTSI. Most upper side is a upstream release. We are taking 4 to 5 months of the preparation time. For it means that around 2 of upstream release will be happen. That means the newer driver or newer features will be included into upstream. Then that will be backported on top of LTS, so that we are able to use on top of LTS and some more features already merged into upstream, or maybe self-contained patches also accepted. On top of LTS, that is more valuable to use for industry. That is our development process. And merge window period will be 2 months. And the most of the patch will be reviewed by Greg Hartman. And sometimes in the Linux Next, merge in the Linux Next will be accepted because of a self-contained patches will be no negative influence to the LTS. And in the validation period, all the contributor must be tested and report back to LTS, LTSI mailing list, so that people can share the result of the testing for the LTSI. So number of companies contributing to LTSI, so that actually lots of testing happened in the backside of LTSI. That's the current situation. Okay. And LTSI is a part of option of Yocto project, so everyone can easy to use LTSI using Yocto project. That is a good relationship with Yocto. And Yocto is doing their own testing for their distribution with LTSI, so that we can easy to use Yocto with LTSI with a tested situation. That is a good relationship. And also many of report and blogs are in the internet, so we can easy to look at such actual situation or how to use Yocto and LTSI in the internet. Sorry. We also have a Fuego auto test packages. As Tim Bird, chair of this conference, he mentioned it's a fast date. Fuego is really useful for auto test packages, Jenkins-based using Docker, and distributed under BSD licenses. This is already included 50 of test packages, so people are everyone, it's easy to use Fuego for their own devices. So Fuego is run on top of some of a server or PC and connected to the board. And then Fuego will translate the test package to the board, and the test result will be able to see by the web interfaces. This is really nice. And a good name called Fuego is named by Tim Board. And this is already used number of actual project. And this is reference in implementation, but works really good. And some of the use case is, one of the use cases is automotive grade Linux. AGL is doing the reference, developing a reference implementation. It's called, name called UCB. It was released in this year, early this year. Version 1.0 is using LTSI 3.14. I went to a session of AGL, but they didn't mention they are using LTSI, but it's already decided. So I asked a number of times, please say using you, AGL is using LTSI, but this time it's not yet. But they are already demonstrated in the CES this year, January this year in Las Vegas. And version 2.0 was released in this July, also using LTSI. And version 3.0 is planned to be released early next year. All these are planned to use LTSI with Yocto project. Another use case is civil infrastructure platform. As you can see in the booth, the second floor, CIP had been established this year, February this year, and Toshiba, Hitachi, Siemens, and other companies get together to create a reference distribution for an industry use case for the civil infrastructure system. One of the major requirements of them is to use more longer terms, called super long term support, 10 to 15 years. It's really long, but the idea is taking over the end of life of LTSI, then they will take over the maintenance. That is, we have number of discussion with CIP people, and good relationship is continuous. This is another important point. How about this year's LTS? Mostly, number of times, LinuxCon Japan will happen in June-July time frame. We have discussed with Greg how about this year's LTS and decided some version and announced. And then LTSI development process was happened. But in the last year kernel summit, it was suddenly kernel developer decided 4.4 will be next LTS. We were surprised. And in this LinuxCon Japan, it happened in July. We have discussed with Greg, how about this year? And Greg mentioned that probably this year's LTS will be discussed in the kernel summit. This year's kernel summit was planned on October 30. So this year's LTS is not yet fixed. But after some that discussion was happening in July, and in September, Greg stated on his Google Plus, and next LTS will be 4.9. And that is good information, that because a pre-announcement is really important for industry use. And then there were a number of discussions happened at the kernel summit mailing list, and maybe moved to 4.8 or 4.10 if people send unready patch to upstream. Because of including a number of patch into LTS version, it's much easier to use. But if it's unready, it is not good. So that is the reason why he mentioned this. And also in the kernel summit mailing list, lots of discussion happened about the upstream first or industry first or such kind of things. The LTSI was started to fill the gap between industry and community, but still in the embedded industry have such kind of gap. But so that we will continue to work for LTSI and have this kind of discussion and trying to align the gap between industry and community. Here is an expected schedule. 4.8 was released October 2nd. And if the kernel summit will happen October 30, the discussion in the kernel summit happened and decided 4.8 will be LTS. Then 4.8 LTS will be started in the time of one redevelopment cycle. It means middle of December. And in another case, in the discussion in the kernel summit, and it will happen, the 4.9 will be next LTS, then 4.9 LTS will be released in the time of 4.10. That may be probably end of February. And also, LTSI development schedule takes us about 7 months, so that in case of 4.8, LTSI 4.8 will be released in middle of July next year. And in the case of 4.9, it will be end of September. So this means that this year, LTSI will not released, but please wait until this July or September next year. That is the current situation. I discussed with Greg Kohartman in the first day. He mentioned that 4.8 was already finished, and now is a merge window. And lots of proposal with good proposal is happened, and Linus is aggressively included, so that it seems that 4.9 will be a good candidate for a long-term use. So that hopefully 4.9 will be a next LTS. That is new information. And we will keep you informed by using a mailing list or Twitter and some other materials. And after we decided the time frame of release of LTSI, then we will announce it. That is current situation. And so stay tuned for what will happen in kernel summit in the end of this month. That is the situation. Okay? This is the end of my slide. LTSI was started to fill the gap between community and industry. But still, there is a gap. Industry people don't want it to send parts to upstream, but this is not good. The upstream is only the place to send. Welcome to help. Oh, okay, thank you so much. Get back. But this one was a really important point for my presentation. And we have well coordinated ecosystem. We have worked with Yocto and we have Fuego. This is really useful for developing our own product. And also a strong use case is ongoing, so that feedback from AGL or Fuego or feedback from CIP will be provided to LTSI. So why don't you join LTSI? That will be really helpful for industry people. That is all of my presentation. Thank you so much. Are there any of comment or question? Oh, no, no. Okay, please. Best time frame of what? Sorry?
So how long, what is the like maximum that you think that is?
Maximum time frame for what?
Support.
Okay. LTSI lifetime is 2 years. It's a the LTSI is basically same as the LTS time frame, the lifetime. So that if the 2 years lifetime is finished, then LTSI also finish the support lifetime. So after that, people should move to another kernel because we will shipping, releasing every year just one version and maintain 2 years. This is our situation. Is that the answer for your question? But if someone wanted to use more longer term, then try to look at CIP or AGL, what is happening. That is another more longer term possible to maintain more longer term. Okay.
You mentioned the handover from LTSI over to the Siemens guys.
Yeah.
Is that like a guaranteed step or?
No, it's not no guarantees. Okay. Yeah. So that after 2 years lifetime, we will not be able to maintain. So that someone wanted to use more longer term, then create some party to fund the developers to maintain some more longer term. That is the current situation. So AGL and CIP try to do that. Okay. Yes. Not selected. Anyone can propose during the merge window period, but Greg will review. That is, Greg is strictly following on the upstream manner, so that the proposal patch should be included in the upstream or at least in the Linux next or more self-contained. That is. Our process. Okay. Are there any of questions? Okay. We will have another. Okay. We will have workshop tomorrow from 10 a.m. at Salon 70 for more discussion about this year's kernel. And also how industry can align the community. And, but Salon 17 is really a limited seat. If you wanted to join and not yet let us know, then please now let me know. So it's a seat is limited. But we are welcome to join us. Okay, that's all. Thank you so much.